In today's class, we will study about the magnetic field due to a current element, which is given by the Biot-Savart's law. Okay, according to the Biot-Savart's law, the magnetic field due to a current element. Okay, let me take this as the current element. This is IDL. At a point P, which is at a distance R from this conductor, making an angle theta with this one, is given by the formula dB is equal to mu 0 divided by 4 pi, mu 0 by 4 pi, IDL divided by R square cross R cap. This is Biot-Savart's law in vector form. dB is equal to mu 0 divided by 4 pi. Mu 0 divided by 4 pi, IDL cross R divided by R square. The term mu 0 is called absolute permeability of vacuum. Absolute permeability of vacuum, V-A-C-U-U-M, is the absolute permeability of vacuum, and the value of mu 0 is equal to 4 pi into 10 to the power minus 7. The unit that will tell you, that is Tesla. The unit of magnetic field is Tesla. Tesla, you can see, this is meter square. Meter square, there is 1 meter. Tesla meter. There is meter square coming here. There is another meter coming here. So there will be Tesla meter per ampere. This is the value of mu 0, which means mu 0 divided by mu 4 pi is 10 raised to minus 7. Now, another thing we are going to discuss as we discuss with electrostatics is the relative permeability mu r. Mu r is equal to mu divided by mu 0. What is mu? Mu is the absolute permeability of the medium, and mu 0 is absolute permeability of free space. So this is also an important thing, and please understand, mu r is like epsilon r, is a dimensionless quantity. Okay, now we have got the vector form. Now this can also be written as, this magnetic field can also be written as, this is equal to mu 0 divided by 4 pi IDL cross R divided by R cube. We will put modulus vector R. So magnitude of this R is what it means. How do we got this transformation? See, what is the reason for this transformation? I will tell you, this is also an important equation. So we use the identity of vectors. Unit vector r cap is equal to vector r divided by modulus of vector r, which you have studied in first year with the chapter vectors. So this is what is Biot-Savart's law for a current element. What is current element? A small current carrying element is called a current element, which is a vector quantity. Yes, this is the result you have to understand regarding dB. Yes. Now moving on to the next idea, that is regarding the similarities and the differences between Biot-Savart's law and Coulomb's law. Similarities and difference between Coulomb's law and the Biot-Savart's law. So according to Biot-Savart's law, we have seen, which is proportional to 1 by R square, right? And the magnitude, another thing I failed to forget to say, is the magnitude of dB is equal to mu 0 by 4 pi. The magnitude of unit vector is 1, IDL divided by R square. Mu 0 by 4 pi into IDL divided by R square. Now, two more things I have to say here. The first thing is, it's cross product, correct? Cross product means the resultant vector is perpendicular to the components constituting the cross product. So I can say first one is dB is perpendicular to IDL. Second one is Second one is DD is perpendicular to R. That is a basic formula of cross product. DB is perpendicular to IDL. DB is also perpendicular to R. Which means I can say, what is the direction of magnetic field due to this current? This is the direction of IDL. This is the direction of R. So IDL cross R at any point is directed. At that point is directed into the plane of the paper. IDL cross R is directed into the plane of the board. IDL cross R is directed into the plane of the board, which can be understood just by this rule. Now see, this is the direction of current at this point. Now see that this is the conductor. Now what I would like to tell you is to do is to hold this conductor in your right hand in such a way that the thumb is in the direction of current. Thumb in the direction of current. Then the magnetic field at a particular point is given by the direction of the current of fingers. You can see here, it is directed into the board, into the plane of the board. As you can see, I am curling it into the plane of the board. Ready? So this is the direction of magnetic field due to a current element. Now we will consider the next area as I was proposing. Similarities and differences. As you have seen, Coulomb's law. Field E is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 q divided by r square, right? 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 q divided by r square. Electric field is proportional to 1 by r square. Now, according to the Biot-Savart's law, dB is equal to mu 0 divided by 4 pi IDL sin theta divided by r square. IDL sin theta, sorry, IDL sin theta, my mistake, IDL sin theta divided by r square. IDL cross R, A cross B, I use IDL, A cross B is equal to magnitude of A into magnitude of B sin theta. Now magnitude of unit vector R is 1, so that's the reason why IDL sin theta divided by r square. Yes, coming on to this point. So both the fields are proportional to 1 by r square. As you can see, electric field is 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 q divided by r square. E proportional to 1 by r square. Biot-Savart's law, mu 0 divided by 4 pi IDL sin theta divided by r square. That also proportional to 1 by r square. Alright. Then the second point is, both obey the principle of superposition. What is the principle of superposition means? According to our knowledge, the resultant electric field is equal to E1 plus E2 plus etc. plus En. Similarly, we can say magnetic field B is equal to B1 plus B2 plus etc. plus En. Okay, this is another thing. Now, please understand, Coulomb's law is applicable only for a point charge. In the similar way, Biot-Savart's law is applicable only for a current element. This is very, very important. Biot-Savart's law, cannot be taken for a whole conductor. It is applicable only for small elements. Biot-Savart's law is applicable only for small elements. He cannot take it for a bulk conductor. Take it for small element, next element, just like the way integrating you may get for the whole conductor. So that is an important thing regarding Biot-Savart's law. It is applicable only for a small conductor. Ready? Now, let us come to the difference between the Coulomb's law and the Biot-Savart's law. Difference between Coulomb's law and the Biot-Savart's law. The first difference is that electric field is constituted by charge. Electric charge. Whereas magnetic field is produced by a current source or moving charge. Right? If the charge is stationary, only result is electric field. If the charge is moving, it will produce both electric field and magnetic field. Current is constituted by moving charges. Okay, so
A moving charge can cause both electric and magnetic field, but please understand that since a current carrying conductor is electrically neutral, a current will produce magnetic field. A current will produce a magnetic field. That is what is observed by Oersted. A current is producing magnetic field. So electric field is produced by a scalar source named charge, whereas magnetic field is produced by a vector source, nothing but a current element. Now the next thing we have to say is that there is an angle difference of B. So dB, as we have seen, it is proportional to sine theta. It is proportional to sine theta. That is another thing. Now the one more difference is there. The third difference I have to say is that electric field at a point is along the line joining the charge and that point. Now what about magnetic field? Whereas magnetic field is perpendicular to the line joining the charge. Magnetic field is perpendicular to the line joining the charge and that point. Magnetic field is perpendicular to the line joining the charge and that point. That's the difference between that. These are the differences. Generally, difference is more than similarity. So please understand that the similarities are that both depends on 1 by r square. Second one, both obey the principle of superposition. Differences, when it comes to the differences, electric field is produced by a scalar source, whereas magnetic field is produced by a vector source. Electric field has no angle dependence, whereas magnetic field has angle dependence. The third difference is that electric field is along the line joining the charge and that point, whereas magnetic field is perpendicular to the line joining the charge and the point. Now, one more thing you have to do is magnetic field due to a moving charge. Magnetic field due to a moving charge, as proposed by D.O. Savas-Lewis, dB is equal to mu 0 divided by 4 pi q into V cross R divided by modulus of R square. This is the magnetic field produced by a charged particle. Magnetic field due to a charged particle is mu 0 divided by 4 pi q into V cross R. This is the magnetic field due to a charge. Magnetic field produced by a charged particle is given by mu 0 by 4 pi q into V cross R. This is the relation for magnetic field due to a moving charge. Now we will discuss about the magnetic field due to a currently carrying circular loop. Now here I am going to use D.O. Savas' law for that purpose. But please understand an important point, that I cannot apply D.O. Savas' law as a whole for this conductor. Why not? The rule says so, that it is applicable for small current carrying elements. So what will I do? I will take a small current element here, which is directed in the z direction. Let me take, this is x direction, this is y direction, the other one is z direction. Now I am considering current element. I can use my left hand for this purpose, left hand rule. This is the direction of IDL, this is the direction of R, this is IDL cross R, means the resultant is given by this rule. Now see, this is the point where I need to find out the magnetic field. This is the direction of resultant vector. Let me say small r. Applying Pythagoras theorem, I can say small r is equal to. Okay, this is 90 degree, as you can understand. Small r is equal to what? Root of x square plus capital R square. X square plus capital R square. Now see, as I told you, ideally is directed out of the plane of the board. R is likewise. So angle between ideal and R is 90 degrees. So I can say the magnitude of the field, is equal to mu 0 divided by 4 pi ideal sine 90 divided by R square. Ideal sine 90. This is ideal. This is R. Ideal sine 90 divided by R square. Now you can see this is the direction of dB. The direction of dB is going to be this. This is the direction of dB. This is the direction of dB. This is the direction of dB. dB is in this direction. dB is in this direction. dB is in this direction. Which is perpendicular to R. Which is perpendicular to ideal. Ideal, it is perpendicular to, this is the direction of ideal, this is the direction of R, so this is the direction of dB. Then you can understand just by using your left hand rule. Now let me take this side, the angle between capital R and R and small r as theta. So my question is, what will be this angle? That angle, obviously we can see alternating here angles theta, this angle is going to be 90 minus theta, which means this angle is theta. Alrighty. Now this is the value of dB. Now I am taking a diametrically opposite element. Since here the current is in this direction, here it is in the opposite direction, right? I am saying it is coming out of the board. Current is here this, as you view from this side, if you view from this side, the current is likewise. This is how the loop is located. Okay, yes. Now this angle is theta. Now here, ideal is into the board and R is likewise. This is into the board and this is the direction of R. R is in this direction, ideal is into the board. And you can see the direction of the magnetic field at this point. What is the direction? This is the direction of dB. Magnitude wise both are same. Now let me tell you one more important point. Here this angle is theta. So obviously this angle is also going to be theta because it is symmetric about this axis. This angle as well as this angle is going to be same. Now which means, what about this angle then? This angle is now coming out to be theta, so this is also going to be theta. Now you can say dB resultant, both are of same magnitude. This is dB, both are of same magnitude. I can say dB resultant is equal to, as we have two elements or two vectors of equal magnitude. Or we can just resolve this into components. Okay, this I am just wiping out. This is theta means this is dB. This is dB sine theta. Now this is dB sine theta. dB sine theta, they are equal but opposite, surely they will cancel each other. Now this becomes dB cos theta. This is also going to be dB. Okay, yes, with your permission. The x component of this is also going to be dB cos theta. So we have how many dB cos theta here? Both are at the same direction. Both dB cos theta are in the same direction. So I can say the resultant field is 2 dB cos theta. Now that is 2 into mu 0 divided by 4 pi ideal divided by R square Now from the figure you can see what is cos theta. Adjacent side is cos theta is equal to adjacent side by opposite hypotenuse. Adjacent side by hypotenuse, which is capital R divided by small r. So that is capital R divided by small r. Now you can say dB resultant is equal to mu 0 divided by 2 pi. I into capital R divided by small r is this much, small r cube, capital R square plus x square, the whole raised to or root of this much, sorry, the whole raised to 3 by 2. I am getting it as small r into so small r square into small r is equal to small r cube. That is equal to root of r square plus x square the whole cube. Root means 1 by 2, that is what I got here. Okay, multiply by b. Now what should I do? I need to find out the resultant field b. That is equal to mu 0 divided by 2 pi I r divided by r square plus x square the whole raised to 3 by 2. Now integration, I have to do the integration. I found out the field due to this element, this element. Now I have to integrate this function. Within what limit? When I take one limit, one element here, I am taking another opposite element. If you take an element here, you will take another element here. If you take an element here, you will take another element here. So that means the limit of integration should be, when you consider one semicircle, ultimately you are also considering the other semicircle, right? At a time, you are taking one from one semicircle, one from the opposite semicircle. So that means the limit of integration should be integral 0 to pi r dl. This is equal to mu 0 divided by 2 pi into I into integral dl is L, L is equal to pi r, there is one r here, divided by r square plus x square the whole raised to 3 by 2. Now I am coming to my result. The magnetic field between current carrying circular loop B is equal to mu 0 divided by 2. Mu 0 divided by 2. I r square. How I got this 2? Because pi cancel. I r square divided by r square plus x square the whole raised to 3 by 2. This is the expression 4. This is the expression for the magnetic field due to a current carrying circular loop at a point on its axis, which is at a distance x from the center. I repeat, the magnetic field due to a current carrying circular loop of 110, the loop was only 110, magnetic field due to a current carrying circular loop of 110 of radius capital R at a point P on its axis, which is at a distance x from the axis of rotation, is given by this expression B is equal to this much. Now let me take this expression. If the loop has n pairs, what will be the answer for the magnetic field? Mu 0 divided by 2 I r square by r square plus x square the whole raised to 3 by 2. This is the magnetic field at the center, field at a point on the axis due to 110. If you have n tens, this answer must be multiplied with n. This is the answer. Magnetic field if the loop has n tens. Ready? Now, next thing, loop has
entrance. Fields at the center. Field at the center of the loop. Loop of entrance, and you are asked to find out the magnetic field at the center of the loop. So center means what is x is equal to?
0.
Center means x is equal to 0. Which means I will get magnetic field B is equal to mu 0 I r square n divided by 2 into r square the whole raised to 3 by 2. This is mu 0 n I divided by 2 into r. This is the magnetic field at the center. How I got this answer? If this is n I r square divided by r cube. I'm sorry. So we can see magnetic field B is equal to mu 0 n I divided by 2 r. This is the magnetic field at the center of a currently carrying circular loop. The very, very important expression I am coming to. The magnetic field at the center of a current carrying circular loop is B is equal to mu 0 ni by 2 r. Now that is, if x is much much greater than r, if x is much much greater than r, well, the formula for magnetic field B is equal to mu 0 n I r square divided by 2 into r square plus x square the whole raised to 3 by 2. Right? Now, look at this situation. In this case, I am saying the point x is at r of, and we have already seen that the resultant magnetic field is always going to be along the axis of rotation. The resultant magnetic field is always going to be along the axis of rotation. Now, we see that here, I am writing as mu 0. Okay, as x is much much greater now, r square plus x square is approximately x square. So it's actually mu 0 divided by 2 into n I r square divided by x cube. How I got x cube? R square plus x square the whole raised to 3 by 2. X square the whole raised to 3 by 2. That is x square into 3 by 2, which is x raised to 3. This is why I am getting this answer. Okay. Now, this relation looks somewhat similar to the field due to a short dipole, short electric dipole. Now, I am going to do one thing. I am going to write this as mu 0 divided by 4 pi. I am going to multiply with the 2 pi on both sides. 2 n I into pi r square. But what is pi r square? That the whole divided by x cube. What is pi into r square? Area. What is current into area? Magnetic dipole moment of a loop. Current into area is the magnetic dipole moment of a loop. Now, one loop, we have n loops, means total magnetic moment, which means this result is equal to mu 0 divided by 4 pi into 2 m by x cube. And this is quite an interesting result, which we have seen in the electrostatics. Before that, what is m is equal to I into pi r square into n, which is equal to n I a, as we have seen in one of the previous classes. In one of the previous videos, we have got magnetic moment m is equal to n I a. And let me tell you, magnetic moment is a vector quantity. And this result is analogous to the result E is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 2 p divided by x cube, which is the result for a short electric dipole. Now here I said x is much much greater than r, which means compared to this distance, the circular loop is
very small in size, x much much greater than r. That means the radius of the loop is very small compared to the distance of separation. In that situation, I can say circular loop can be treated like a short magnetic dipole of magnetic moment given by I into pi r square into n. Okay, this is the magnetic field due to current carrying circular loop. Now the next thing before we wind up this session is we need to find out the direction of magnetic field due to current carrying circular loop. Okay, let me consider the situation that this is carrying a current in this direction. Now here this is the axis and the direction of magnetic field is along the axis of rotation, which can be determined using the right hand thumb rule. And what is the right hand thumb rule? Curl the fingers of your right hand in the direction of thumb. Curl the fingers of your right hand in the direction of thumb. Sorry, direction of curled fingers, current. I'm sorry. I have gone wrong. Curl the fingers of your right hand in the direction of current, then the thumb will represent the direction of magnetic field. I repeat. Curl the fingers of your right hand in the direction of current, the thumb will represent the direction of magnetic field. That means this is in this direction. This is the direction. It asks you a path of the force loop. This is the direction of magnetic field. Now, as we know, the field around a current carrying conductor is in concentric circles, just like the way you can see here. Actually, it's a superposition of the fields due to these small elements. Okay. So now considering the graphical representation of magnetic field with the x, we can see that as x is very large, field is proportional to 1 by x cube. This is the shape of the graph between magnetic field and the distance x along the axis. The maximum is at the center, which is mu 0 ni divided by 2r. The maximum magnetic field is at the center of the circle and also r is mu 0 ni divided by 2r. So this is regarding field due to a current carrying circular loop and Biot-Savart's law. Hope it is clear to you.